Have you ever felt like your photos library is a chaotic mess? Today, I'm going to teach you how to transform that chaos into order with my easy-to-follow workflow. If this is your first time watching, I recommend watching the entire video once all the way through just so you understand the workflow. Then come back and watch it again as you follow along step by step. Before we begin, let me explain the overall workflow. The first step is to move your local photos library to an external drive. This ensures that we have a backup while we're organizing your library. The next step will save you multiple hours of work. If you've watched my class on how to organize your photos in the past, this is the part where I'd normally have you create a folder for every year, and then we'd use this thing called a smart album to help organize your photos. So check this out. Instead of spending hours upon hours creating this complex structure, now you can download it pre-assembled from my website. Think of this as the California Closet's approach to organizing your photos. After that, we're going to connect this brand new library to your iCloud account so it can download all of your photos into it. Finally, in the last steps, I'll show you how to rapidly convert groups of photos into albums. One little disclaimer before we begin, you do need to use iCloud Photos for this process to work. I realize probably 99% of you already do this, but I had to throw it out there. Okay, without any further ado, let's begin the class. As I mentioned a moment ago, the first step is to move your photos library to an external drive. So let's have you open up a Finder window and navigate to the Pictures folder. If you don't see a shortcut on your sidebar, just press Command-Shift-H, which will take you to the Home folder, and then double-click on the Pictures folder. And in here, we're looking for the file called Photos Library. Now, I want you to copy and paste that library into your external drive. After that file has finished copying, and you've verified that the size of the Photos Library on the external drive matches the size of the file on your Mac, I want you to delete the library that lives in the Pictures folder on your Mac. Next, head over to my website at techtalkamerica.com, and here on the homepage, if you scroll down just a little bit, you'll see that I now have two products. One is my Organized Documents folder, that's the video from a couple weeks ago, but below that is the Organized Photos Library. It costs $20, but trust me, it will save you hours of work and frustration. After you've paid, please do not close the window because it will then send you to WeTransfer. Now click I agree at the bottom left and then click download. This file will appear in your Mac's downloads folder and you'll now want to move it to the pictures folder. Then double click on it to launch it. Let's now take a look at the contents of this library template. The first folder I want to bring your attention to is the To Be Organized folder and I want to briefly explain how it works. One of the big complaints I got the last time I taught this class was from people who had spent a lot of time creating albums. Understandably, they did not like the idea of deleting their old albums, so instead, I have created a folder, and after we connect this library to your iCloud account, we're going to move all of your old albums into this folder so that we can then move them into the appropriate years. Under Albums, you'll see that I've created a folder for every year, and inside each folder, there are two Smart Albums, which are represented by the gear icon. The Smart Album with the year on it is going to help us organize your photos into traditional albums. The other Smart Album will only show you videos that were captured in that particular year. If we scroll to the bottom, you'll also find a folder called Home, and inside that, there are two albums. One called Home Inventory, and the other called Home Renovations. So anytime you encounter those types of photos, you can just drag and drop them into those albums. There's also a folder called Hobby. This is where you can put images of things like artwork, craft projects, or some other type of hobby that might not fit into a normal yearly structure. You'll also see an album called Wrong Date. This is for any images that are pre-digital and that were scanned into your library. When you encounter those images, drag and drop them into the Wrong Date album, and we can reassign the dates later. The next step is to connect this template library to your iCloud account. So at this point, I want you to click where it says Photos at the top left, and then go into Settings. Here under the General tab, I want you to click Use as System Library. This tells your Mac to sync this library with iCloud. Please be aware, after you click this button, there is a very good chance that you'll get the spinning beach ball. If you do, don't panic. Just let it do its thing and have the expectation that it may take several minutes. Now I want you to click over to the iCloud tab and turn on iCloud Photos. Below that, you'll see options to optimize your library or download originals. My advice is to set it to optimize for now, and only if you have enough hard drive space, you can then switch it over to download originals later. But for the time being, just set it to optimize. At this point, you should start to see your photos restore from iCloud. Depending on how many photos you have, as well as your internet connection speed, this may take some time. You'll know that it's done when you go to the very bottom of the library, and here it should say, synced with iCloud just now. If you have many older albums that you would like to keep intact, the next step is to drag them into the To Be Organized folder. For this example, I have a single album that I've created, so I'm going to drag it into that folder. But for all of you, you'll probably have many more. We're now going to double-click on the To Be Organized folder, and now all I need to do is drag and drop my old albums into the appropriate folder on the left. If you can't remember what year an album took place, just double-click on it and you'll see the date at the top left. If you don't have a lot of albums that you've created over the years, I want you to go to My Albums and select those older albums and then hit the delete key. I realize a lot of people freak out when they hear me say delete all of your old albums, but I would just like to remind you that deleting albums does not delete the photos inside those albums. It's like deleting a playlist in the music app. The songs, or photos, are still there. Only the organization is removed. Okay, at this point we need to talk about the smart albums that live inside each of these folders. A smart album is a way for your Mac to automatically group photos based on certain criteria. The smart albums that I have created for you have two rules. The first is pretty obvious. Show me all of the photos that were captured between January 1st and December 31st of that particular year. The second rule is album is not any. What this basically translates to is you're telling it to only show you photos that have not been organized into albums. When you're organizing any type of data, you need to remove it from the equation once it is organized. So that's where that comes into play. You'll also notice I've created a second smart album that only displays videos for a particular year, including ones that have been organized. That way, if you ever want to create something like a year in review video, you have all of your videos in one place. The last few steps involve using the smart album with the year on it to turn groups of photos into traditional albums. The reason why this is important is smart albums do not sync to iOS devices, so that's why we need to convert them into traditional albums. Let's do a couple of these together just so you get the hang of it. For this example, let's go to my smart album for 2023. We went on a cruise that year from Australia to New Zealand, so I'll select those photos by clicking on the first. Then I'll hold the Shift key and click on the last image in this group. As you can see, every photo in between is now selected. At this point, we need to use a keyboard shortcut to create a new album from this selection. That shortcut is Command N. But one little tip I want to give you is hold down the Command key and tap the N key. The reason why is if you hold the N key, it's going to rapidly duplicate that album. As you can see here on the sidebar, the album takes on the name of the smart album, which is the year, so now I'll just type over that and give it a name. Don't bother putting the year into the title because remember, it's living inside of a folder that has that year. Then hit enter to lock it in. Let's do one more together. Also in 2023, we took a little trip to Provincetown, so once again, I'll select those photos by clicking on the first, hold the Shift key, and then click on the last photo in the set. Now I'll press Command N to create an album and give it a name. Finally, tap Enter to lock it in. So now you'll just need to repeat those last three steps over and over. Select a group of photos, press Command N, give it a name, and tap Enter to lock it in. Here's another tip. By focusing your energy on the most important photos, when you're done processing a year of photos, the only photos that will be left were the ones that didn't justify having albums and junk. So this is why this presents a perfect opportunity to do some spring cleaning. You remember how earlier I told you that deleting a photo out of an album does not delete it from the library? Well, deleting a photo from a smart album does delete it from the library. Remember, a smart album acts like a search filter for those specific photos. So when you're done organizing the photos that you care about, you might consider selecting the images that you don't care about and then delete them. As I mentioned earlier, one of the albums I created for you is called Wrong Date, and anytime you encounter photos that were scanned, you'll want to drag and drop them into that album. To reassign the dates to those photos, just select them and then go to the image menu and click on Adjust Date and Time. I wouldn't worry so much about the day and month, just focus on the year. By doing this, when you're in the library view of your photo library, those images will appear at the beginning instead of when they were scanned. Here's another tip, and this one can save you a ton of time. If you're the type of person who tends to take multiple photos of something, hoping that one comes out, but then you never take the time to go back and delete the other 10, go watch my tutorial on how to use an app called Photo Sweeper. This app finds all of the similar photos and makes it easy to eliminate all but one. Keep in mind, if you have any questions about this workflow, or if you feel more comfortable having someone hold your hand through this process, you can work with me remotely from the privacy and comfort of your own home. I've come to refer to this not as tech support, but as tech therapy. To sign up for a one-on-one session, please visit my website at techtalkamerica.com. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.